I talked to a counselor the other day up in Maine who said, I've been at this for 30 years. Kids know me and they trust me and they come and share their issues with me. Said one Tuesday afternoon, I'm sitting in my office towards the end of the school day. A young woman comes in, a 16-year-old, shuts the door, throws herself into my side chair, bursts into tears, and says, a month ago, my best friend confided in me that she had a serious eating disorder, and she swore me to secrecy, made me promise never to tell a soul. And in the last month, I've watched her get thinner and thinner and weaker and weaker, and I think she's going to die, and I don't know what to do. If all that counselor knows about ethics is that it's a matter of right versus wrong, that counselor will see no relevance whatsoever for moral reasoning in this story because nobody has done anything wrong. It is not wrong to be sick. It is not wrong to be weeping over what you're going to do about your friend. It is not wrong to be a counselor trying to console a weeping teenager. There is no wrongdoing anywhere on the horizon. If, on the other hand, that counselor recognizes that what is tearing this young woman apart is a right versus right dilemma in her own life, where, on the one hand, she knows that she has to speak the truth about this situation. On the other hand, she knows that she has promised confidentiality and given her word. That's the challenge. And you can build as powerful a moral case as you want that when you give a promise, you keep your word. And over here, you can build as powerful a moral case as you want that when death is threatening your friends and by speaking up you could save a life, you speak up. And the question is not that she has no morals. The question is that this young woman is so imbued with a sense of values that that's what's tearing her apart. In fact, if her values were less powerful, she might not even see this as a problem. She sees it as a problem because she has an ethical stand. And your task, and the counselor's task, is to help her work through that, understand the pressures that are coming to bear on her, and hopefully, in this case, be able to bring her to the point of saying, look, keeping your promise is absolutely right. But in this circumstance, there may be a higher right. That doesn't make this other right wrong. It says that on balance, it looks like the scale ought to tip in this direction. And of course, you know as I, the kinds of responses that will come back to that. But if I rat on my friend, she'll never speak to me again. Yeah, but at least she's alive to make that choice. What's more important, preserving your own sense of feeling good about yourself or saving a life? I mean, come on, let's think about the big picture here. And that is a moral conversation. That is an ethical conversation. And that's why these tools are so valuable in these situations.